Good morning, everyone. myself, Apoorv, and I'm going to take some classes of polity and geography, although from today, we are going to start some elucidative and some technical topics of geography. I hope so you've gone through the whole syllabus. I hope you know the whole conceptual part, the technical elucidative topics basically dealing with the geography or geographical aspect or illustration. I hope so you've gone through the whole syllabus. My question is simple. Syllabus dekha sabne? So can you tell me or trace me ki which particular topic of geography which is specifically mentioned by the commission in some papers of GS? I mean, I'm taking the regard of paper 1, 2, 3 and 4. Any particular specific topic of geography, physical, Indian, resource geography, economic geography, human geography, which are mentioned or has been delineated, of course, by the commission in your syllabus, can you tell me? Geography ka koi topic mentioned hai syllabus mein ki nahi hai? It is there. Then which topic? Come on. Which topic, please? Distribution of world resources. Yeah, that's right. Climate. And? Achha, it is basically mentioned paper 1 or paper 3. Mail in paper 1. Precisely, of course, in paper 1. Okay? So, when we take the regard of the of this module, I mean, of course, geographical module, let me delineate and craft you ki which particular topic is mentioned in your syllabus, one thing, and which particular topic we have to cover in the coming time, second thing. Okay? So, let me, of course, do the whole delineation work over here ki sequentially we have to cover which topic and in which format and how we are going to conceptualize the whole syllabus. Okay? So, just here. The very first topic or section which is mentioned in your syllabus, mainly in paper 1, is called as physical geography. Now, the physical geography is the most technical, the most elucidative, illustrative, penological topic dealing with your syllabus. I mean, of course, the most conceptual topic basically of the whole syllabus of geography. Achha, when we take the regard of the physical part of geography, I hope you have heard about it, ki under the ambit of physical geography, we are including or we are incorporating or we have incorporated actually three specific sections. Okay, the very first section is the geomorphology. Okay, geomorphology. Achha, geo literally means earth. Morphology means studying the structure of earth. I mean, of course, all the physical features which are present over the surface of earth. It can be in the form of landforms, relief, mountains, plain, plateaus, okay, different type of valleys and so forth. So, geo literally means, of course, earth. We have to study the earth. Achha, under the ambit of geomorphology, not only we have to study all the physical features which are present over the surface of earth, but also in the intrinsic layers of the earth also. I mean, below to the surface of earth. So, apart from the physical features which are there over the surface of earth, we have to consider the interior chemical composition of earth also. So, there's a whole delineation of geomorphology. I mean, of course, what? The physical part of geography. Achha, with geomorphology, there is one more section of physical geography which is mentioned and crafted, of course, by the commission in your syllabus called as what? The climatology. Climatology is nothing. Sorry? Okay. So, climatology literally means, of course, basically a type of mass energy exchange mechanism between Earth and atmosphere that we will discuss in the coming time. But abhi filhal ke liye samjho ki climatology literally means to study the climatological zones from equator towards pole and different type of weather pattern over the surface of earth again from equator towards where? Pole. So again we have to of course take the regard of one more elucidative topic of physical geography called as what? The climatology. The climatology. Achha, with geomorphology and climatology, there is one more section which is mentioned in your syllabus, of course, under the ambit of physical geography. And this time the section is called as oceanography. Oceanography. Okay, that means different type of oceanic movements which are taking place over the surface of Earth in different categories of water bodies. I mean Pacific, Atlantic, Indian Ocean, Southern Ocean, different type of seas, bays, gulf and so forth. And all the physical features which are present over the oceanic bed but below to the sea level that I will discuss in the coming time. So, there are three broad sections of physical geography that we have to take the regard of: geomorphology, climatology, and which one? The oceanography. Achha, with the physical part of geography, I mean the three sections of physical geography. There is one more section which is incorporated or which had been incorporated in our syllabus called as biogeography. Okay, again when we are taking the regard of the biogeography topic, it is mainly dealing with the environmental and ecological aspect of geography. Okay, so I'm not going to touch of course the topics of biogeography because I hope so. In the previous classes, the topics of environment and ecology had already been covered. So we are not going to touch of course these topics, and mainly I'm going to focus on the three important topics of physical geography, the geomorpho, the climate, and which one? Oceanography. So sabse pehle baat hame is pe karni hai. Achha, with the physical part of geography, there is one more section which is there of course in your syllabus. Take a call as of course the resource geography. Take a resource geography. Different type of minerals, rocks, strata, ores, consideration, configuration, and so forth over the surface of Earth. Okay, different type of industrial location we have to study. Okay, different type of agriculture pattern, irrigation pattern we have to consider. So again, the resource geography is also a very important topic with regard to, of course, your main syllabus that we'll discuss in the coming time. Okay, with resource geography, there is one more section called as Indian geography. Indian geography. Okay, so all the concepts of what we have built, okay, under the patronage of physical and of course resource geography, I mean the world geography, we have to apply in the case of what? Indian geography. We have to study the physical features of India, the whole climatology of India, okay, the oceanographical features of different water bodies like Arabian Sea, which one? Indian Ocean, okay, and of course Bay of Bengal also, okay. So every concept what we have discussed or what we have illustrated, okay, of course under the ambit of these topics, physical and resource geography, which also include world geography, we have to apply in the case of which one? The Indian geography. At last, we are having the last topic in this section called as what? The human geography. Human geography, I mean the human aspect of the geographical mechanism, like topics like urbanization, migration, population pyramids, okay, population transformation, and these type of topics are mentioned in your syllabus. Okay, so in broad manner we have to cover of course all these topics. I'm going to start my discussion of course between the physical part of geography, then we'll discuss of course more on human and other part of geography. I hope so the whole delineation is clear, the whole crafting work. Okay, let's start the topic. Chalu kare. Chalo, before starting the first section of this module, I mean of course a geography, I want to ask some questions from you with regard to this section. Mera ek perception hai, perception nahi balki persuasion hai, aur wo ye hai ki I think after class 9th 10th, I hope so, I'm presuming that you have not touched any of the topic dealing with geography. Matlab jo 9th 10th mein choda hoga wo kisi ne fir dobara nahi pakda hoga. Acha, anybody has geography optional? Geography optional, great. Anybody who has read geography, of course, in your academics, geography background, I mean, of course, quite obvious. Chalo, so few aspirants are there. So, but of course, majority of the aspirants does not know the conceptual part of geography. One thing is quite clear. So, we have to start from the scratch. Acha, why I'm starting from the scratch? It's because be very sure about it. Ki I'm having a perception, as I told you before, persuasion also. Ki generally, we are having a thought, I mean, of course, a perception in our conscious, unconscious mind, ki we or I know a particular concept. But when we have to illustrate, define the same concept, we always find ourselves wanting. Hum ye soch ke chalte hain ki I know a particular concept, of course, in topics like science and tech, geography, economics. But when we have to illustrate it, define it, elucidate it, okay, then, of course, we are not able to do so. I want to give a simple example over here. Just say, ki when I ask, ki what do you understand by continent? Define continent. Achha, in our conscious, unconscious mind, we are also having or always having the feeling that, ki I know what is continent, what's the big deal in that? But when we have to define a very simple connotation, I mean, of course, a very simple term called as continent, please define it. Then what is island? Achha, every continent is covered from all the sides by water bodies. What about Asia? What about Africa? Europe? Huge? Huge chunk of landmass, that's continent. The most appropriate crude definition of a continent, that means nothing but the huge landmass. What do you mean by oceans? How oceans are different from seas? Ab ye mat bolna, wo bada ye chota, ye mujhe pata hai. What are oceans? I hope you know very well ki India is designated as a subcontinent. But only India is referred as a subcontinent. So ऑफ कोर्स इंडियन सबकॉन्टिनेंट इंक्लूडिंग पाकिस्तान, ठीक है. तो द इशू इज, तो ये तो पॉलिटिकल बाउंड्रीज वाली बात हो गई, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट फिजिकली. सो व्हेन वी टेक द रिगार्ड ऑफ इंडिया, इट्स रिगार्डेड एज अ सबकॉन्टिनेंट. सो माय क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर इज कि व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कॉन्टिनेंट एंड हाउ द कॉन्टिनेंट इज समवॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सबकॉन्टिनेंट. इनिशियली गिव मी अ वेरी कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव, कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव छोड़ो, वेरी क्रूड कॉन्क्रीट डेफिनेशन, प्रिसाइज डेफिनेशन ऑफ ए कॉन्टिनेंट. एनीवन, एनीवन फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी बैकग्राउंड? जी क्या हुआ? सो माय कंसेप्ट ओवर हियर इज, और माय परसेप्शन ओवर हियर इज कि ऑलवेज इन अवर सबकॉन्शियस, कॉन्शियस, अनकॉन्शियस माइंड वी आर हैविंग अ परसेप्शन दैट कि आई नो अ पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट. कॉन्टिनेंट में क्या है, बचपन से पढ़ते आ रहे हैं, सेवन कॉन्टिनेंट है, ये है, वो है, सब कुछ है, लैंडमास, ह्यूज लैंडमास है. बट वेन यू टू डिफाइन इट, वी आर नॉट इन अ पोजिशन टू इलस्ट्रेट और डिफाइन अ पर्टिकुलर कॉन्सेप्ट. आई होप यू गॉट माय पॉइंट, हैंस प्रूव्ड. तो माय कंटेंशन ओवर हियर इज कि आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द स्क्रैच एंड इन द कमिंग टाइम, ऑफ कोर्स इन द कमिंग क्लासेस, वन और टू क्लासेस, आई एम बेसिकली ट्राइंग टू बिल्ड योर कॉन्सेप्ट. आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स बेसिकली वी विल डिस्कस मेनली ऑन द कॉन्सेप्चुअल पार्ट, क्योंकि देर आर सो मेनी टॉपिक्स और देर आर सो मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट, इनहेरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट विद इन फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी दैट यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड ऑफ कोर्स बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टेक्निकल टॉपिक ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल. आई होप इट्स क्लियर. सो इन द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास, आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स टुडे एंड ऑफ कोर्स टुमारो, आई एम गोइंग टू बिल्ड योर कॉन्सेप्ट डीलिंग विद द फिजिकल पार्ट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एंड देन विल स्टार्ट द टेक्निकल टॉपिक. इट्स अ हाईली टेक्निकल इलुस्ट्रेटिव टॉपिक ऑफ योर मॉड्यूल, आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स ऑफ योर सिलेबस. अच्छा, मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर कमिंग ऑफ कोर्स फ्रॉम फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी, दे आर कमिंग मेनली इन मेंस, ठीक है. सो अगेन इन अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव मैनर वी हैव टू कवर ऑफ कोर्स एवरी टॉपिक, बट बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू बिल्ड अवर कॉन्सेप्ट ओवर हियर, एक चीज. सेकंड थिंग विथ ज्योग्राफी, जैसे कि आपको समझ में आ रहा होगा, इट्स अ वेरी मोनोटोनस टाइप ऑफ, स्टीरियोटाइप टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक, वेरी टायरी, ठीक है, पूरा जूस निकाल देता है, ठीक है. तो और कॉन्सेप्चुअल भी काफी है. तो व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू ओवर हियर कि पर डे और ईच डे आई एम ऑल्सो गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन सम कंटेम्प्रेरी इशूज डीलिंग विद ज्योग्राफिकल टॉपिक्स. आई मीन ऑफकोर्स आई होप यू नो वेरी वेल कि वन टॉपिक विच इज मैंशन इन योर सिलेबस एंड दैट इज अर्बनाइजेशन, विच रिक्वायर्स ऑफकोर्स सम कंटेम्प्रेरी स्टडीज ऑल्सो. तो आई एम ऑल्सो गोइंग टू फोकस ऑन सम इंपॉर्टेंट इनिशिएटिव टेकन बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन द रीसेंट पास्ट इन द अर्बन सेक्टर एंड अदर सेक्टर ऑल्सो, इंक्लूडिंग एजुकेशन, हेल्थ, ठीक है. सो ऑन डेली बेसिस आई एम गोइंग टू कवर ऑफकोर्स वन गवर्नमेंटल पॉलिसी और गवर्नमेंटल प्रोग्राम, ठीक है. लाइक इन द अर्बन सेक्टर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज स्टार्टेड और हैड स्टार्टेड सो मेनी प्रोग्राम्स लाइक द स्मार्ट सिटी मिशन, अमृत मिशन, आई होप यू हर्ड अबाउट इट, ठीक है, द प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना, स्वच्छ भारत मिशन, रूरल अर्बन मिशन, ठीक है, श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी, ठीक है, नेशनल रूरल अर्बन मिशन और रूरल अर्बन मिशन, ठीक है. एंड देर आर सो मेनी प्रोग्राम्स विद रिगार्ड टू द हेल्थ सेक्टर एंड ऑफ कोर्स अदर सेक्टर ऑल्सो. सो ईच डे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर ऑफकोर्स वन गवर्नमेंटल पॉलिसी, ठीक है. बट बेसिकली माय यू कैन से बेसिकली कंटेंशन वुड बी टू डेवलप योर कॉम्पिटेंस विद रिगार्ड टू द सेम प्रोग्राम. एक मैं एग्जाम्पल देना चाहता हूँ कि हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू अप्रोच एवरी प्रोग्राम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन द कमिंग टाइम, ठीक है. जैसे टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ओवर हियर कि देर आर सम टॉपिक्स विच आर मैंशनड इन योर सिलेबस मेनली इन पेपर टू, विच आर द टॉपिक्स ऑफ कॉमन कॉग्निजेंस, वेरी जनरल टॉपिक, टॉपिक्स लाइक गवर्नेंस, आरटीआई, सिटीजन चार्टर, आई होप यू हैव फॉलोड द होल सिलेबस, ठीक है. तो देर इज अ वेरी वेरी स्पेसिफिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर एग्जामिनेशन एंड द प्रिंसिपल इज कि वैन द कमीशन आस्किंग ऑफ कोर्स अ जनरल क्वेश्चन, ऑलवेज राइट अ टेक्निकल आंसर, बट वैन द कमीशन ऑफ कोर्स रेज अ टेक्निकल क्वेश्चन, यू हैव नो अदर ऑप्शन बट टू राइट एन एवरेज आंसर. आई मीन मोर जनरल द क्वेश्चन, मोर द टेक्निकल एक्सपर्टाइज और टेक्निकल स्पेसिफिकेशन, ठीक है, मोर टेक्निकल द क्वेश्चन, यू कैन ऑफकोर्स राइट एन एवरेज आंसर टू सिक्योर मोर देन एवरेज मार्क्स. बट इन ए जनरल क्वेश्चन, वेन यू राइटिंग ऑफकोर्स ए जनरल एवरेज आंसर, यू आर नॉट इन ए पोजिशन ऑफकोर्स टू सिक्योर हाई मार्क्स. जैसे टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, ठीक है, कि आई होप देर आर सम टॉपिक्स विच आर बेसिकली द टॉपिक्स ऑफ कॉमन जनरल कॉग्निजेंस लाइक करप्शन, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, क्लाइमेटिक चेंज, ठीक है, आरटीआई, आरटीई, एजुकेशन इंक्लूसिवनेस, डेलिक्वेंसी एंड सो एंड सो फोर्थ, ठीक है. अगर मैं आपसे बोलता हूं कि करप्शन के बारे में कुछ लिखिए, 100 वर्स, 200 वर्स, यू आर इन पोजीशन टू राइट समथिंग, यू आर इन पोजीशन टू राइट समथिंग. इफ आई गिव ऑफ कोर्स सिंपल क्वेश्चन टू यू, अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन अबाउट आरटीआई और आरटी, अगेन यू आर इन पोजीशन टू राइट समथिंग, आई होप सो, ठीक है. आई आस्क सम सिंपल क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम यू लाइक व्हाट डू अंडरस्टैंड बाय आरटीआई, राइट टू इन्फॉर्मेशन, और नरेगा, और करप्शन, और ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, या जो ठीक लगे आपको वो समझ लो, ठीक है. चलो एक एक्सरसाइज करते हैं, मुझे बताओ मैं क्या करना चाह रहा हूं आपको, कि इफ आई आस्क अ सिंपल क्वेश्चन अबाउट यू और टू यू एक्चुअली कि व्हाट इज आरटीआई, राइट टू इन्फॉर्मेशन, आई होप यू ऑल हैव हर्ड अबाउट आरटीआई, नरेगा, मनरेगा, टेल मी व्हाट इज आरटीआई. हम्म,
and they are accountable to us. And there are some fields in which we cannot ask information. There are some scientific or defense sectors of the government.
Some informations are classified. RTI Act 2005 implemented. It was RTE 1st of April 2010. मतलब बेवकूफ बनाने का तरीका था क्योंकि 1st of April से शुरू हुआ था. खैर पर वो RTE था, not RTI. खैर तो I hope you are in a position to write something. Like if I ask simple question about Manrega, Narega, education inclusiveness, financial inclusiveness, social delinquency, women empowerment, feticide, तो कुछ ना कुछ लिख दोगे आप लोग, ठीक है. But if I ask some technical, somewhat technical question from you, like ki illustrate the provisions of Indian Patent Act 2003 by taking the special reference of market mechanism, theek hai, under the domain of TRIPS Agreement 1996. To pehle to aapko ye pata ho ki what is Indian Patent Act 2003, then the whole pronouncement of TRIPS Agreement 1996, and under TRIPS Agreement and of course what Indian Patent Act 2003. ठीक है, अ मैकेनिज्म कॉल्ड इज व्हाट, मार्केट मैकेनिज्म. इफ यू आर नॉट इन अ पोजीशन ऑफ कोर्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोविजंस ऑफ ट्रिप्स एग्रीमेंट और द पेटेंट एक्ट 2003, ठीक है, यू आर अगेन नॉट इन अ पोजीशन ऑफ कोर्स इवन टू राइट इवन अ सिंगल वर्ड. तो माय कंटेंशन ओवर हियर इज कि इट्स अ वेरी टेक्निकल क्वेश्चन एक्चुअली. सो इन अ टेक्निकल टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक्स और क्वेश्चन व्हेन यू राइटिंग ऑफ कोर्स अ वेरी सिंपल एवरेज आंसर्स, ठीक है, यू आर इन अ पोजीशन टू सिक्योर मोर देन एवरेज मार्क्स. बट इन अ जनरल क्वेश्चन व्हाट आई आस्क यू ऑफ कोर्स, व्हिच आर मेनली कमिंग ऑफ कोर्स इन पेपर 2, in a general question when you are writing of course a very average answer or below to average answers, again you are not in a position to secure more than average marks, aur aap waise hi competition se bahar ho jate ho. Jaise when we have to define or technically we have to define RTI or Manrega or any other topic, theek hai, just see how we can build our technical competence over here. Jaise I am taking the regard of RTI, right to information, kyunki general topic hai ye, theek hai, ki RTI is basically a citizen gateway that create a new set of legal relationship between the people, I mean the citizens and the state, okay, by incorporating, okay, some progressive principle of governance, okay, like transparency, accountability and responsiveness, with the purpose to transform the representative democracy into participative one. That's RTI. I hope you get your point. So in these 5 or 6 terms or connotations or nomenics, okay, I have shown my technical competence of course to the examiner. It is nothing but a citizen gateway that created new type of legal relationship. It is not a social relationship at all. It's basically a legal relationship between the state, state means Article 12, and of course the people, the citizens. Okay? By incorporating some progressive principles of governance, the transparency, accountability, and responsiveness. Responsiveness here means the government should be proactive, not reactive. And the purpose is to provide, of course, access to the people in the matters of policy formulation, policy implementation, policy monitoring and of course policy evaluation. I mean, okay, the main purpose is to change or transform, not change but transform the representative democracy into which one? The participative democracy. I hope what I want to tell you over here. So my contention over here is ki more general the question, more technical the answer. More technical the question, you have no other option but to write an average answer or below to average answer. But in a technical question, if you are writing of course what? A technical answer, it's a high chance that of course you are going to secure less than average marks. However, in a general question, if you're writing, of course, what an average answer, below to average answer, without showing the technical competence, again, you are not in a position to secure more than average marks. Just take one more example over here. Ki Narega or Manrega is a matter of very common cognizance. Sabne suna hoga uske bare mein. Theek hai? So when we have to define Narega in our introduction, how we can define it? Ki Narega or Manrega is a demand-driven, labor-intense, employment generation program based on approaches like motivation dismotivation approach, self selected approach and right based approach. Ab ye baat alag is par hum log discuss kar sakte hain, theek hai. According to MS Swaminathan, it is nothing but the world's largest program for environmental conservation. That's Narega or Manrega. So in these 5 or 6 terms, again I have shown of course my technical competence over here. Demand driven approach, labor intense approach, theek hai, some strategies like motivation dismotivation, right based approach, self selected approach and so and so forth. Umeed hai meri baat samajh rahe ho, theek hai. So again we have to compare of course or cover every governmental scheme by building your technical competence or by building my technical competence also, theek hai. So in a more technical manner, of course each day I am going to cover one governmental policy or one governmental scheme. I am going to start my discussion of course with geography, from a very important elucidative topic basically of human geography called as urbanization. And here I'm going to cover, of course, every scheme started by Government of India with regard to urban revitalization, urban rejuvenation, and urban-urban infrastructure transformation. Okay? So with physical geography, we are going to compare or cover, of course, some topics of what? Contemporary issues also. Every governmental policy, each day sequentially and chronologically. Let's start physical geography. I hope contention clear. Start kare. Chalo, to ek just title likhiye. fundamentals of physical geography. Fundamentals of physical geography. Physical geography, as we know very well, the three specific topics or streams, the geomorphology, climatology, and oceanography. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Geomorphology, climatology, and of course, which one? Oceanography. Haji, please. Let's start. Chalo. So, basics of physical geography. Acha. Initially, I'm starting with the fundamentals of geomorphology. Geo means earth, as I told you before. And under the ambit of geomorphology, of course, I'm going to use some mnemonics or terms in the coming time, in the coming future. So let me clarify all the concepts under the ambit of this particular module or stream of geomorphology. Acha, the very first concept what I'm going to use in the coming time is relief. Relief. Okay? With relief, of course, one more term I'm going to use frequently or in the coming time, in the coming classes, and that is landform. I hope you heard about landform. It's a very common term or connotation, the landform. With relief and landform, again, one more term, one more connotation I'm going to use frequently in the coming time. Or wo hai, of course, the topography. Topography. Okay? With topography, of course, one more term, and that is the physiography. The physiography. Okay? With physiography, of course, one more connotation. The term is terrain. I hope this is a very common term, terrain, you heard about it. And the last term is nothing but the structure. Okay? The structure. Agree? So, geomorphology is nothing but the study of relief, landform, topo, physio, structure, and of course, what terrain. The question arises over here, ki what is relief? Anyone? Yeah, please. The difference between the elevated areas or the highest and the lowest point is called as relief. Okay? Any other specification about relief? And what's the basic difference between relief and landform? I hope you heard about it, ki desert is nothing but a landform, valleys are landform, mountains are landform, plateaus are landform, but they are also relief. So what is the basic segregating point between the relief and, of course, which one? The landform. Anyone? Relief is a very broad connotation, and under the ambit of relief, we are, of course, incorporating the landform. Dekho, simple bhasha mein samajhte hain, then we'll discuss, of course, in technical manner. Ki relief literally means any type of elevation or depression from the surface. Acha, here surface means, of course, the sea level. Be very sure one more time. Ki if we have to delineate an oceanic water mass and a continental land mass, we are using, of course, a very simple figure, somewhat like this. Okay? So here I'm showing the continental land mass, and this is nothing but the oceanic water mass. Okay, the level or the surface of an ocean is called a sea level. Okay, and the floor of the ocean is called as oceanic bed. Oceanic bed. Okay? So relief literally means, of course, any type of elevation or depression from the surface. Surface here means what? Sea level. Any type of elevation and depression, okay, from the surface, the sea level. Can I use a simple concept over here? Okay, that means, of course, what the mountains are relief. Mountains, plains, continental landmass, the oceanic bed, they all are relief. Okay, any type of undulation, heaps and mounts over the surface of Earth, maybe over the continental surface or might be over the oceanic bed, they are coming under the purview of which one? Relief. ठीक है, लाइक द प्लेट्यूस आर रिलीफ, द वैलीज आर रिलीफ, द प्लेन्स आर रिलीफ, ठीक है, द सैंड ड्यून्स आर रिलीफ, ठीक है, द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कॉन्फिगरेशन लाइक रिफ्ट वैलीज आर रिलीफ, वी आर स्टैंडिंग ओवर अ रिलीफ, कॉन्टिनेंट्स आर रिलीफ, ठीक है, इट मीन्स ऑफ कोर्स एनी टाइप ऑफ एलिवेशन डिप्रेशन फ्रॉम द सी लेवल, तो कॉन्टिनेंट भी रिलीफ है एंड ओशनिक बेड्स आर ऑल्सो रिलीफ, व्हाट डू यू से, सो एनीथिंग ओवर एंड बिलो टू द सी लेवल इज नथिंग बट वॉट रिलीफ. अच्छा, सम रिलीफ्स आर एब्सोल्यूट. एब्सोल्यूट हेयर मीन्स ऑफ कोर्स वॉट द नेट एलिवेशन फ्रॉम द सी लेवल और द नेट डिप्रेशन फ्रॉम द सी लेवल, वाइल सम रिलीफ्स आर रिलेटिव. अच्छा, वेन वी टेक द रिगार्ड ऑफ रिलेटिव रिलीफ, इट मीन्स ऑफ कोर्स जस्ट हियर ओवर हियर कि इफ देयर इज अ रिलीफ कॉल्ड एज अ माउंटेन, ठीक है, लाइक हिमालयस एंड एडजेसेंट टू द माउंटेन ऑफ कोर्स वी आर फाइंडिंग अ प्लेन कॉल्ड एज अ ग्रेट नॉर्दर्न प्लेन. So the average elevated difference between the mountain and the plain is called as what? Relative relief. So everything and anything over the surface of earth having some undulation as compared to the sea level is called as what? Relief. But there's a slight difference between the relief and the landform. Basamishna. Ki when we are taking the regard of relief, relief means the net elevation and depression, no issue at all. In net form or gross form, jo bhi kehna chaho. But when we consider landform, okay, landforms are also relief. They are also relief. But in the case of landform, we are studying the distinct shape of a relief feature with its process of origin. Shape could be elongated, circular, flat, elevated, steeper, 2D, 3D, 4D, chhod do. Okay? So shape kuch bhi ho sakta hai. So when we study, of course, the distinct shape of a relief feature, it can be in the form of mountain, plateau, and so forth. Okay? The study of the distinct shape, okay, is of course categorizing the relief feature as what? Landform. अच्छा, नॉट ओनली वी आर स्टडिंग द डिस्टिंक्ट शेप ऑफ रिलीफ फीचर बट इट्स प्रोसेस ऑफ ओरिजिन. देखो, सम रिलीफ्स आर मेड अप ऑफ कोर्स इग्नियस रॉक, सम आर सेडिमेंटरी, सम आर मेटामॉर्फिक ऑफ कोर्स इन ओरिजिन. सम रिलीफ्स आर क्रिएटेड बाय अ कैटास्ट्रोफिक इवेंट कॉल्ड एज अर्थक्वेक. सम रिलीफ डेवलप एंड इवॉल्व ओवर द सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ बाय वॉल्केनिक डिपोजिशन लाइक डेकन प्लेट्यू. सो व्हेन वी स्टडी द डिस्टिंक्ट शेप एंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ ओरिजिन ऑफ ए रिलीफ, ठीक है, द होल कोनोटेशन और द कंसिडरेशन or the conceptualization is called as what? The landform. Okay? So, but just based on the shape and of course the consideration, we are of course categorizing or segregating the relief and the landform. I hope you get the point. Okay? There's a very interesting observation I'm giving to you. Is baat ko samajhna zara, ki some reliefs are highly visible for the naked eyes, what we can take the cognizance of, like mountains, plateaus, valleys are visible. Achha, although some reliefs which are relief, but they are present below to the sea level.